Hi friends, today I am going to tell you the most famous about Shahi Paneer. The name itself gives us so much of happiness. The way our Punjabi culture is full of colors and vibrance, the same way Shahi Paneer gives us, it just melts like a beautiful aroma and tingles. So let's start the recipe. Let's start with the ingredients first. So the recipe, we're taking the paneer, half kg of paneer, we cut into square cube pieces. Then this is half kgs of tomatoes, we boil them and blanch them and then make a puree out of them. For the masalas, we just take 1 tablespoon of cumin grounded powder, 1 tablespoon of coriander grounded powder, 1 tablespoon of garam masala, which is freshly grounded at home. There is one secret to this recipe, that we soak about 10 to 12 cashews in the water and make puree out of it. And then there's another option, that we take carnation milk about 2-3 tablespoons. Then we have oil to start with, garlic ginger paste 2 tablespoons, and in the end we have a bit of kasuri methi and salt. So let's start with it and enjoy. Now we are going to just put oil, this is olive oil, to just make it very very healthy. Actually it is not healthy. Okay, now let the oil be little hot. We put this garlic ginger paste and we just let it golden, just keep doing till it is golden brown and it start giving that aroma of, you know, the color. It will give a very beautiful flavor of garlic and ginger paste. You just keep sopping it for a while so that, you know, it gets really dark brown. It will just take 5 minutes for this to get golden brown. So I think it's almost there. It's almost there. And now we will put the tomato puree which we have made. We are allowed about, as I told you, it's half kgs of tomatoes. You have to boil and just keep boiling them, and then peel them and then blanch them in the mixer. It's already ready here. I'm just waiting for it to just get a little bit more brown so that I can just mix it in it. It's already now dark brown. Let it boil a bit and blend into the masala that we have put. So after we put the tomatoes inside, we have to simmer at least 15 minutes to get the gravy in a thickened mode. When we see that the full thing, like full gravy, is getting thick, we can start putting our masalas. First is the cumin powder to put into it, then coriander powder, as we had told you, and after that the garam masala we put. We can see the gravy getting more nicer and more, you know, the flavor and gravy. Now we just move it for a while, keep stirring it for a while. Then we have made cashew gravy to make it look thicker and nice. We'll put that in. We can see the color changing, and now the gravy is in very thick mode and it's looking nice. For some reason, people like to put few colors here and there, but I don't think so. We should go for any artificial flavors or colors. Just let it be natural and very, very easy to make. Now, we can see the gravy thick and nice. It's all up to you. If you wanted to make it more bright red, you can make it, or any other purees you can put it, but I just feel that the simpler the better. Yes. And then we put salt in the end, towards the end, when we see the gravy is getting thicker. And then we can just keep stirring it, make it. And actually this salt was 1 teaspoon according to 1/2 kg of shahi paneer, but you can always see your taste and you can put, that has to be according to individual's taste. And in the end we just put this little bit of kasuri methi, so that gives a beautiful color and texture. Once this gravy is fully done, we let it simmer for another 5 minutes, and when the gravy is done, here is paneer, and just we put paneer before serving on the table. And now before serving on the table, when you see that everybody is sitting, just put superficially the paneer pieces into it and don't mix it so much. Just move lightly because everything is done. And this is almost ready to put in the bowl to keep it on the table. And again in the end, if you want, you can just have a little bit of carnation milk or a little bit of cream, which I have kept. If you want to put, you can put into it. It all depends on individual's taste. I don't prefer, so I don't put. But if you want, you can just go in. So now, we are already done with the gravy, with the paneer and everything we have mixed together. Now let's put it in the bowl to serve. Garnish with anything you want. You can garnish with a little bit of cream, or you can garnish with a little carnation milk, or a little bit of coriander leaves if you're comfortable. And we are ready with our shahi paneer. Thank you so much.